Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Forces on a hammerhead. A hammerhead is placed at point 1 and the I-beam is placed at point 2. The distance between point 1 and point 2 is 3 meters. When the hammerhead is dropped, then I-beam will move downward and will cover a distance of 7.4 centimeter, and this new position is point 3. So the distances are given here. Distance between point 1 and point 2 is 3 meter, and the distance between point 2 and point 3 is 7.4 centimeter. We will use the work energy principle and we will calculate the velocity of the hammerhead at point 2 and the average force the hammerhead exerts on the I-beam. These two are the target variables, and it is also given that mass of the hammerhead is 200 kg. Frictional forces are 60 newton. When the hammerhead moves downward, frictional forces are there, and the value of the frictional forces is given as 60 newton. So we will use the work energy theorem and we will calculate the velocity of the hammerhead at point 2 and the force exerted by the hammerhead on the I-beam. First step is to identify the relevant concept will be the work energy principle, and we have to find the velocity of the hammerhead at point 2, that is V2, and we will have to find the force exerted by the hammerhead on the I-beam, that is N. Second step is setup. First we will draw a simple sketch of the situation. Then we will draw the free body diagram of hammerhead. So we will place a drop for the hammerhead, and there are two forces acting on the hammerhead. First is the weight that is acting downward. Second force is a frictional force acting in upward direction of a magnitude of 60 newton. The velocity of the hammerhead is in downward direction, and we will attach a set of coordinate axes. So this is x-axis, and perpendicular to it is y-axis. Next we will draw the free body diagram of hammerhead when it is pushing the beam. We will place a dot for this hammerhead. When the hammerhead is touching the I-beam, there are three forces acting on the hammerhead. First is the weight of the hammerhead, that is toward the center of the earth. Second is the frictional force of 60 newton. And third is the normal reaction. As there is a contact of hammerhead with the I-beam, so the third force is the normal reaction N, and this normal reaction is in upward direction. We will attach a set of coordinate axes, x-axis, and perpendicular to it is y-axis. And the velocity of the hammerhead is in downward direction. I-beam is also moving downward. Hammerhead is also moving downward. So the third step is to execute. We have some data. First we know that the distance between point 1 and point 2 is 3 meter. This is S12, and the distance between point 2 and point 3 is 7.4 centimeter or 0.074 meter. Mass of the hammerhead is 200 kilogram. Then the weight of the hammerhead will be 1960 newton. Since the hammerhead is stationary at point 1 and at point 3, therefore the velocity at point 1 and at point 3 is 0, or we say that v1 is equal to 0 and v3 is equal to 0. Next we will make some calculations between point 1 and point 2. This is the point 1 and this is point 2. We will apply the work energy principle. And work energy principle states that total work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. So between position 1 and 2, the change in kinetic energy is K2 minus K1. And work is the product of force into displacement. The net force between point 1 and point 2, the net force is mg minus small f. And the displacement is S12. So we will write as W total is equal to net force, and this net force is W minus small f. into displacement between position 1 and position 2. So the displacement between position 1 and position 2 is 3 meter, and V2 is the velocity at point 2. This is to be calculated, and the velocity of the hammerhead at point 1 is V1 is 0. So after putting the value, weight of the hammerhead is 1960. Frictional forces are 60 Newton, and distance between point 1 and point 2 is 3 meter. And here the value of the mass is 200 kilogram, and V2 is to be calculated. V1 value is 0 and the result is 0. So in this equation, only V2 is unknown. After simplification, the value of velocity becomes 7.55 meter per second. This is the first target variable we have calculated. So consider position 2 to 3. Here, the velocity at point 2 is V2 and velocity at point 3 is V3. And we will apply the work energy principle. So total work done is equal to K3 minus K2. The change in kinetic energy is K3 minus K2. K3 is the kinetic energy at position 3 and K2 is kinetic energy at position 2. The total work done is equal to the net force multiplied by the displacement. So net force will be W minus F minus N, and displacement is S23. S23 is 7.4 centimeter. So W total, this is the net force between position 2 and position 3 and to the displacement S23. Expression for K3 is half mv3 square and for K2 is half mv2 square. After putting the values, we know that W is equal to 1960 Newton. Value of frictional force is 60 Newton. This is normal reaction, and S23. S23 is 7.4 centimeter or 0.074 meter. The value of V3 is 0, therefore this factor will become 0, minus half m and V2 square, putting the value of mass and V2. In this equation, only normal reaction is unknown. After simplification, the value of small n becomes 79,000 Newton. Next step is to evaluate when the hammerhead touches the I beam, normal reaction becomes 79,000. The downward force that hammerhead exerts on the I beam has the same magnitude of 79,000 Newton, and this is more than 40 times the weight of the hammerhead. So our result is true. Thank you very much for watching this video.